Hello and welcome back. ZDBIG here with a new tutorial. Today, I'm gonna walk you through how you can create the knife throwing effect from Dave Ardito's video. If you haven't watched the first and second video of this series yet, I suggest you do by clicking on this card up here or just check the links in the description below. And now, without further ado, let's get started.
All right, bring your clip into a new composition. Then bring your clean plate. I will right click on it and choose time, freeze frame, and then extend it for the entire composition. And now I will rename it to clean plate. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is to look for a realistic 3D knife model. And I found this one on sketchfab.com. It's for free. I will leave you a download link in the description. So I will download the OBJ version of this knife. And now I will create a new solid layer. Call it knives, and then go to effect, video copilot, element, click on scene setup, and now we're gonna import our 3D knife model into element 3D. Drop down, and for the texture I will use the textures that came along with the model. It looks realistic, as you can see. Now I will right click on it and go to auxiliary animation and choose channel 1 and then hit OK. Alright, this is our knife. So go to group 1, under aux channels, channel 1, rotation. And from here I'm gonna play around with these rotation values till I get the rotation I'm looking for. I will go to particle loop, particle rotation, and change these rotation values as well. Yep, like this, it looks fine. It has to be towards the camera. Now click on particle replicator, and I'm gonna change this particle count number to 4, because I want them to be 4 knives. And for the particle size, I'm gonna lower it just a touch. I'm gonna change this replicator shape to sphere, and then I'm gonna play around with these rotation values till I get the perfect rotation I'm looking for. There are no exact values that needs to be added. Just keep messing around with these rotation values till you get it right. Like this. Now I will go to the frame where I'm gonna throw the knives, and under particle replicator, I will increase the Z position, then add a keyframe for both Z position and X and Y position. I'm gonna adjust the position so the knives kind of fly out from my hand. Then I'm gonna move a couple frames forward, and now I'm gonna lower the Z position value and adjust the X and Y position so the knives become in the center, as you can see. Yep, it looks good. I will lower the Z position a bit more. Okay, so I want the knives to start moving from this frame. So I will go to the knives layer and select both first keyframes, and I'm gonna delay them just a couple frames and then trim the layer like so. I'm gonna trim the layer a bit more. Okay, now it looks better. I will just go to the composition settings and make it a bit larger, then extend the clean plate like so, and then right here I will press Ctrl plus Shift plus D on this clip, and now right click and choose time stretch, and increase the value to 250%. And now what's gonna happen is that the subject is going to be in slow motion. And now move forward a couple frames, and now I want to lower the Z position even more. So now you see what happens: the knife slows down for a couple seconds and then flies out. I will move this keyframe like so, then select both and move them a bit farther. Yep, now it looks better. And of course, always enable motion blur. Okay, I think I'm gonna select this keyframe and remove the Bezier interpolation as well. So select linear. Move this one closer a bit and change it to linear as well. Okay, I think now it looks better. Alright, I will go down here to render settings, then select motion blur, turn it on and change this value to 360. Yep, it looks more realistic with the motion blur. Alright, so what I'm gonna do now is go to Effect, Color Correction and choose Curves. Now select the blue channel and increase it like so. Then add a keyframe, move backward in time and change the curve back to its normal position. Press U to reveal the keyframes and I will move this one like so. It looks good. And now I'm gonna bring these lightning disperse effects. Then add the optical glow effect from Red Giant. Increase the amount, size, highlights only, and highlights roll off. Then on the alpha channel, change it to generate unmult to get rid of the black background. Now I will move the lightning layer like so, and right click on it, go to time stretch 50%. I will scale it down and move it to be exactly where the knives are to get that cool looking electricity effect on the knives. I will position it like so. Yep, it looks perfect. I will trim it from the beginning for a couple frames.
So if you wonder where I get these lightning assets from, don't worry about it, I've got you covered. It's all from AE Juice. This pack called Lightning Effects has a wide variety of electric beams, arcs, slow motion, strikes, impacts, storm clouds, sparks and a lot more. And it's perfect for creating effects similar to Thor, The Flash, Electro, etc. So you can grab this pack for just $72 instead of $144, or you can just grab the whole Triune Digital VFX bundle, which also includes lens flares, magic powers effects, movies special effects, sci-fi muzzle flashes, science fiction LUTs, and slime effects. All that for a generous deal of $347 instead of $967. So, by clicking on this card, you can grab this deal before it's too late. And now, let's proceed with our tutorial.
Okay, I think right here I'm gonna press Ctrl plus Shift plus D. Then on this new layer, I will just move the lightning asset a bit closer to the knife's position and maybe increase the scaling even more. Okay, it looks good. Now on the knife's layer, I will select the last two keyframes and bring them a few frames closer. And now on the subject clip, I will press Ctrl plus Shift plus D again and just delete this part. Then duplicate the lightning asset. Now click on this copy and I'm gonna hold the Alt key and bring this Disperse 7 asset to just replace it. I will position it like so. Maybe move it for a couple frames and then extend it. Yep, now it looks perfect. Now I'm gonna create a new adjustment layer. Then I'm gonna add a chromatic displacement effect to it. Increase the displace amount to 10 and now use the pen tool to draw a mask around the area where you want the displacement to be. Then increase the mask feathering. I'm gonna adjust the mask frames like so. You can see the difference. You can play around with these values as well. And now add a keyframe for the mask path. And now move forward and keep adjusting the mask so it covers all the knives as they move towards the camera. And right here I'm gonna press Ctrl plus Shift plus T and delete this part. And then do the same thing in the beginning as well to get this look. Perfect. You can always adjust the displacement values to your desire. And same thing goes for the mask feathering as well, because that chromatic displacement really helps to sell the effect. Okay, great. Now I'm gonna add a keyframe for the displace amount to be 0 at the beginning. Okay, now I'm gonna select these lightning layers, right click and choose pre-compose. I'm gonna rename it to lightning. And now I'm gonna turn off the visibility for all these layers to start working with the subject. So I'm gonna bring this Atmos 1 asset, lower its time stretch value to 50%. Then bring it right here, and of course add the optical glow effect as always. And adjust the values like so. And now I'm gonna position it on top of the subject. So I will bring this light 2 asset. I will move it to start right on this frame. Now I will copy the optical glow effect from the lightning layer into it. And then just lower the values like so and change the quality to extreme. Okay, just move it one frame. Alright, so keep messing around with the optical glow effect till you're satisfied with the results. Okay, like this, it looks perfect. Now I'm gonna scale it down. And then move it forward in time. And I want it to be only visible for a couple of frames. So right here, I will press Ctrl plus Shift plus D and delete this part to get this look. Drag it like so. Perfect. Maybe trim it even more to get this look. I'm gonna trim the Atmos layer as well. And now I wanna add another asset, which is this Air Blast. Scale it down and position it like so. Then move it to be below the Atmos layer. Just drag it in position and get this look. I think I'm gonna scale the light layer like so. And now let's check how everything looks. Perfect. Now I want to add one more thing. On the subject layer, I will add a roughen edges effect. Drop it like so. Then draw a mask around the subject. Change the border value on the roughen edges effect to 500. Lower the fractal influence. And now add a keyframe for the border. Move backward a couple frames. And lower it back to zero. To get this look. I will increase the mask feathering just a bit. I'm gonna duplicate the subject layer, rename it to subject, and this one to shadow. I'm gonna delete the mask from the shadow layer, then draw a rough mask around the subject, change it to subtract, and increase the feathering like so. I will increase the feathering even more. I have done this trick to keep the shadows in the frame. And now it looks perfect. I'm gonna duplicate the adjustment layer, move it to be below the knives layer, and then delete the chromatic displacement effect from it, and add the heat distortion effect from Video Copilot. I'm gonna increase both heat amount and distortion amount, then increase both nose scale and nose speed as well, and increase the wind speed just a touch. To get that perfect distortion effect. Alright, so on the air blast layer, I will move it like so, because the dust is interfering with the walls. Now use the pen tool to draw a mask around this wall like so, change it to subtract and feather it out. And now it looks more realistic. So select everything, right click and choose pre-compose. Then add a direction blur effect to it. Increase the blur length value. I'm gonna enable motion blur for the comp as well. Then change the blur direction. And now add a keyframe for the blur length. Move forward a couple frames and after the subject disappears from the frame, lower the value back to zero and do the same thing at the beginning. Right here, change it to 0%. Yep, it looks nice. Press S for scale and just increase the scale of this comp to 110. Now I'm gonna add one last effect to it, which is this lens distortion matching from Red Giant. Change the lens type to fish eye, add a keyframe for the distortion, increase the value to around 80, then move backward, change it to 0%, and then move forward like so and lower it to 0 as well, to finally end up with this look. I'm gonna add a CC vignette effect and lower the amount. And now it looks amazing. One last thing I want to add, which is the camera shake effect as always. So I will bring this impact preset and then add the transform effect and fix the clip's position like so. Increase the scale just a bit and change the shutter angle value to 180 degrees, and now this is what you get. I'm gonna increase the scale even more to finally end up with this look.
Alright, that's it guys for this tutorial. I hope you liked the video. If you do, smash that subscribe button and we'll see you guys in the next video.